Hey friend, welcome back to the Sage Audio Channel. Today we're going to be answering the question, what is a music producer? We'll be looking into what the role used to mean and how it's changed over time due to some particularly creative and driven individuals, so stick around for the full video. But first, if this is a topic you'd like to know more about, I'd highly recommend checking out the blog post associated with this video, where you can find a lot more information on this topic and a lot of others like it. So just scroll down to the description box below to find the link. Also, if you're an artist or an engineer, and perhaps you've been producing some music and you have a mix that you need mastered, send it to us at sageaudio.com. We'll master it for you and send you a free mastered sample. All you need to do is set up the short account, upload the song, and we'll take care of the rest. The term music producer used to be more specific, or at least less all-encompassing a term. It referred to an individual that would hire the musicians and engineers, rent the studio, and pair all the right elements together to create a record. Their job was to put all the necessary pieces together to facilitate a record's creation. Now, typically, a record producer or a music producer had been either an engineer or an artist that with time came to know various key players in the music industry. With these connections and the knowledge of who was particularly skilled at a certain job, these producers would organize these elements for the sake of making a great-sounding record. With all these key players in place, they'd schedule the sessions, keep financial records, and a timeline to ensure that the album gets created at or below budget and within a certain time frame. This limited role began to shift as some music producers began to greatly influence the sound of the records they produced. Perhaps one of the most famous examples of this is the work of Phil Spector. His implementation of the wall of sound changed how music was recorded and perceived. Soon, small bands whose records once consisted of their relative instruments were layering stacks of guitars, drums, background vocals, and accompanied by an orchestra. With that said, producers began to call shots with the instrumentation, how it was performed, and the composition behind it. In order to create the sound they wished to have recorded, they needed to control more aspects of the recording process than before. This shifted the role of a producer from a general organizer to an active composer. Additionally, audio engineers soon started influencing the songwriting and composition process. One of the better examples of this transformation from solely engineer to engineer and music producer can be seen when looking at Tom Dowd. After working on a multitude of hit records and landing a job as an engineer with Atlantic Records, Dowd soon learned the music-making craft and became fluent in music theory and the discourse surrounding it. His role as an engineer-turned-producer laid the foundation for our current understanding of the term music producer. This marked the start of engineers having a say in the music creation process. They were no longer simply board operators responsible for recording and engineering. They could also become integral parts of the music-making process. Lastly, let's look at how artists can also become music producers. By now, we can see how the title of music producer has been blurred by many creative individuals taking on multiple roles. Another example of this is when artists start controlling and conducting their own sessions. No longer are they simply songwriters and performers, they're composers, conductors, and all-around producers. A good example of this occurring is with the work of Brian Wilson on his highly influential masterpiece, Pet Sounds. Brian wrote, composed, conducted, performed on, and even had a role in engineering this passion project. He showed that with the right knowledge, an artist can expand beyond their traditional role to create something significant. Today, many artists follow suit as they take a larger role in creating the majority of the instrumentations on their records. The artists formerly known as Prince and Beck are two good examples of how Brian's work influenced other artists' producers. Prince would, and Beck continues to, create multiple layers of instrumentation and vocal performances instead of hiring a band or outsourcing the composing process to another producer or composer. Now, all this to say that the multifaceted nature of the term music producer really just means that there's a lot more flexibility within the music industry than there once was. If you truly wanted to, you could write, record, produce, compose, mix, and master your entire album yourself. Of course, this would be a challenge, but the point is, it's now an option. The term music producer means a lot of things, and it varies from producer to producer. So, what do you think? Is this a topic you'd like to know more about? If so, I'd highly recommend checking out the blog post associated with this video, where you'll find a lot more information on this topic and a lot of others like it. Also, if you're an artist or an engineer, send us one of your mixes at sageaudio.com. We'll master it for you and send you a free mastered sample. All you have to do is set up this super easy to create account, upload the song, and we'll do the rest. But thank you so much for watching. We hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like and share this video with your friends. Also, you can subscribe to the channel. This way you stay up to date on all of our latest releases. There's a comment section where you can leave your thoughts on this video or a suggestion for a future video. And again, if you're an artist or an engineer and you have a mix that you need mastered, send it to us at sageaudio.com. We'll master it for you and send you a free mastered sample. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you in the next video.